सतो मा सत्गमय तमसो मा ज्योतिर्गमय मृत्यो मा अमृतं गमय।
Let us discuss few important cases. In our textbook they mentioned about Keshavananda Bharti case. Keshavananda Bharti case, they also mentioned the year 1973. What is Keshavananda Bharti? If we need to conclude what is Keshavananda Bharti, what was the verdict given by the Supreme Court, first we have to understand the before case. These both are very important cases in related to our constitution. The first case is, this case is Golaknath case is not given in our textbook, but to better understand this Keshavananda Bharti case, first of all we have to understand Golaknath case. Golaknath versus Punjab. The state, this case was between the Golaknath, one person from Punjab, and versus state of Punjab. So this case is related to land issues. In 1967, Supreme Court gave a judgment. Supreme Court gave a verdict. What Supreme Court gave judgment? That is, Supreme Court ruled out that Parliament cannot touch the fundamental rights. Parliament cannot change the fundamental rights. This is the judgment was given in 1967 in Golaknath case. Same, Parliament has zero power, and also they stated that Parliament has nothing, no power, zero power to amend fundamental rights. Parliament cannot amend the fundamental rights. Parliament don't have any power to change the fundamental rights. Also, it was included that preamble is not a part of the constitution. It also mentioned that preamble. Do you know already preamble? First page of the constitution. Supreme Court also gave a judgment that preamble is not a part of the constitution. So these are the major verdict was given by the Supreme Court. Golaknath case, Supreme Court said that Parliament cannot amend the fundamental rights. Parliament don't have any power to change fundamental rights. And also they mentioned that preamble is not a part of the constitution. So these kind of the things it will be advantage for you for your opinion and justice. For opinion, justice, interpretation, they ask your opinion. There, these kind of information, extra information will be useful for you. Here let us come Keshavananda Bharti. The judges of 1967, they gave a different judgment, and judges of 1973, they gave a different judgment. What they gave judgment? Yeah, let us see what is Keshavananda Bharti case. Keshavananda Bharti versus Kerala. Who was Keshavananda Bharti? Keshavananda Bharti, head of the Hindu Mutt in Kerala. Keshavananda Bharti was a person. He is running one Hindu Mutt. It is in Kerala. It is also related to land issues. Land issues. Yo, Supreme Court gave a judgment. What Supreme Court gave a judgment? Supreme Court, they said that Parliament could amend any part of the constitution. You see, here, Supreme Court said that Parliament, no powers of the Parliament here. But what he has said? Here they say that Parliament could amend any part of the constitution, including fundamental rights. Here, court says that no, you don't have any power to change fundamental rights, to amend fundamental rights. But here, Supreme Court stated that Parliament could amend any part of the constitution, including fundamental rights. But it can't change the basic structure. You please understand, this is a very, very important one. They are saying that, but cannot change the basic structure. Parliament can do, but they cannot change the basic structure. What is the basic structure? They also identified. So what is basic structure? Certain principles were given in related to basic structure. Parliament can amend the basic structure. Parliament can amend the constitution, but they cannot change the basic structure without the violation of the basic structure of the constitution. Without the violation of the basic structure of the constitution, they can amend. They can amend.
Yeah.
And another, see, and contrast to Golaknath case, here they gave that preamble is a part of the constitution. I repeat, preamble is a part of the constitution. In Golaknath case, Supreme Court judge said that no, in preamble is not a part of the constitution. But the judges of Supreme Court in 1973, they have changed it. That is a judicial review. They taken this case as a judicial review. They reviewed this Golaknath case and finally they said that preamble is a part of the constitution. So these both are Keshavananda Bharati case was very important case in related to save our democracy. Our democracy is saved because you understand privy process changed and parliament they nationalized the banks. So these are going against of the certain basic principles. You understand? Indira Gandhi 1971, privy purses were abolished, and Indira Gandhi government they are nationalizing the banks. Certain people they claimed the case, they went to the court. Then court believed that parliament is doing more powers, parliament has more power, and parliament can do, but parliament cannot touch the basic structure, cannot violate the basic structure. One more question. One more important question is, now present parliament can make own laws, can make new constitution. I repeat, present now parliament is there. Parliament can write now new constitution. No, parliament cannot make a new constitution. Please understand. Parliament cannot make a new constitution. Just parliament, they have to behave. They have to make certain laws, but not entire the laws. Then who will prevent the parliament to do not exercise more powers? Courts, Supreme Court. Supreme Court is the guardian of the constitution. Supreme Court is the guardian of the constitution. What Supreme Court says, everything will be done within the framework of the constitution. I repeat, everything will be done within the framework of the constitution. Is everybody, means MPs, MP, MLA, government officers, everybody, they are behaving within the framework of the constitution. They are doing their work as per the constitution or not. So that the court will be interpret. The court will be give the judgments. If anybody violate the constitution, court will be punished. The court work is just only interpret the laws. Court will be interpret the laws. Court is the guardian of the constitution. Example, it is a hypothetical question. Now, today or tomorrow onwards, parliament announced that yes, we are ready to make a new constitution. Now, present constitution was not good. Now, new constitution we wanted to write. Then, what will happen, you know? If we plan to make a new constitution, every person in India, they wanted to push, they forced the government to make the laws in favor of them. Example, tribal peoples are there. Tribal people force that we want this kind of the laws, make certain laws in favor of us. OBCs were there. These OBCs will pressurize the government, you make certain laws for us. There was no laws for us in the past constitution. But the recent new constitution, whatever you are going to write the new constitution, so you certain make certain laws in favor of us. Not only that, OBCs, OCs also will do. SCs also will, Dalits also will do. Hindus also will force. Hindus, they say that, no, make the laws in favor of the Hindus only, because we are majority. And Muslims will be says that, no, we are less in numbers, so that make laws in favor of the Muslims. Christians, for that, make the laws in favor of us. So what we understand that, each and every person, they force the government or the body, those who are making the constitution, to make the laws in favor of them. It will lead lot of tension, lot of ruckus, lot of problematic, so that we are not going to make a new constitution. Either it is a parliament or Supreme Court. Supreme Court can't make a new constitution. Parliament also can't make a constitution. Just the Supreme Court is there to interpret the laws. Is everybody, is each and everybody, they are following or not? Okay, so these things Supreme Court will do. I hope you understand. Only one thing you have to understand, that 1973, in Keshavananda Bharati case, Supreme Court said that Parliament can amend anything, any part of the constitution, including fundamental rights, but they do not change the basic structure of the constitution. I repeat, they do not change the basic structure of the constitution. I hope you understand, children. So this is our lesson. Thank you.